Hi, welcome to this particular concept of incredible Michaelite. So here we want to have a concept saying that let's know a Michaelite. So this is basically a virtual digital library we wanted to create for future. Anyone who wants to see what a Michaelite has done over a period of say about 160, 70 years, we have got 1858, the establishment of St. Michael's High School, Patna, Dighaghat, Patna, actually. And it has been a big journey. We have got some stalwarts all across the globe doing fantastically well. In 2020, we have decided that let's create a digital diary, a dictionary which can actually go across to people, go across to these Michaelites all over, and they can view where the Michaelites have been reached. Where are they doing? What are they doing now? And to today's stage, we have got the first session, first webinar session of our school's alumni is, and we have got Mr. Sanjay Singh, his ex-advisor, Tata Sons, and has got a number of meritorious achievements in professional life as well. And Mr. Chandmani Singh, again, he is currently with Reliance. He was the COO of Videocon as well. To a fact that we were supposed to have Mr. Bhaskar Rao on board, but unfortunately, there is a law and order issue in Bangalore because of the death of a Karnataka actor called Chiranjeevi Sarja. So he had to miss down. We'll have him somewhere next time. So let's start. We'll start with our co-host and very popular amongst all, Ambar sir. So we'll have Ambar Banerjee with us. So Ambar sir can start with the school journey, some anecdotes, some good stories about the principals and the teachers and the school itself. Let's start. Ambar sir, off to you. Sir, you're mute. Sir, you're mute, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Nishant. Thank you so much. You see, as it is said, I mean, every Michaelite is a legend. But then as George Orwell said, some Michaelites or some legends are more equal than the others. So here we have a couple of them right in front of you. Okay, we begin with Mr. Sanjay Singh. Hello, Sanjay Bhai, welcome. Hello. Mr. Sanjay Singh was just 1 year senior to me. All right, he, I think, belongs to the 1970 batch. Okay, yes. And of course, Mr. Chandramani Singh, all right, my wonderful, bright, cheerful, crazy student as well. So welcome to you, Mr. Chandramani Singh. Right, now, I'll just first start with Mr. Sanjay Singh. As it is said, Sanjay Bhai, very good times and crazy friends and some crazy, you know, events, all right, and incidents make the best school memories. And maybe I'll just give a little cue. That is, I remember there were two Sanjay Singhs, all right, with 1970 batch. One was, of course, Mr. Sanjay Singh right in front of you, and Mr. Sanjay Singh, another Mr. Sanjay Singh. So this Mr. Sanjay Singh, this legendary Michaelite, all right, is actually Mr. Sanjay Singh. You know, he was addressed as Mr. Sanjay Singh Pol, all right, or P-O-L, okay? But then he was very tall and he's still very tall, okay? And and so, over to you, Sanjay Bhai. Any special memories vis-a-vis teachers, students, and some crazy things that you may have done? I still remember you were there in the radio club and the first crystal set that I made, well, was totally made by you. And I just took it home and took a show to the teachers and I said it's made by me, but then it was all your handiwork. So over to you, Mr. Sanjay Singh.
Thanks, Amber. And great connecting with you after such a long time. Now that you ask me to tell you an anecdote about a character, a teacher from school, and you also talked about the two Sanjay Singh. So let me connect the two together, the anecdote and how I got my name Paul, and the other Sanjay Singh got his name Electric. It happened in class 8, and it so happened that the other Sanjay, we were the same height, and even our clothes would fit each other. We were both in the hostel, and very often when our names would be on the board, the wrong guy would get punished. Once Father Murphy came into the room and he saw the name Sanjay Singh and said, "So which one of you is it this time?" He said, "I must create a differentiator." And in the flick of a second, the idea came to him. He asked me, he said, "What does your father do?" I told him he was in the Indian Police Service. And he asked the other Sanjay Singh, "What does your father do?" He said, "He's in the electricity board. He's a chief engineer." So in front of electric's name, he wrote EL. The blackboard was not enough to write electric fully. He wrote only EL. And there was not enough space on the blackboard to write P-O-L-E. So, P-O-L-I-C-E. So he just wrote P-O-L. Now, many people think that my name Paul has been derived on account of my height. I was just as tall when I was in class 8, incidentally. And which is a good 6 feet. I mean, I was abnormally tall. And this is a name that has stuck with us throughout our lives. Now, we are 60 years out of school, about 55 years since we got this name. But it has stuck with us. I went and saw Electric a few years back in New York. And the keys to his apartment was at a tobacconist. And I was told by Electric, "Go there, say you are Sanjay Singh, and you will get the keys." I go to the tobacco shop and I said, "I'm Sanjay Singh. I believe you are holding the keys to a flat for me." He said, "Ah, you must be Paul." So imagine a complete stranger in New York and, you know, also knew about the story. It happened in Delhi as well. I mean, many a times when I would go with my Tata bosses to meet some eminent people, you know, they would address me as Paul, and which would confuse my, you know, Tata Sons bosses, because they always knew only as Sanjay Singh.
All right.
Sanjay Bhai. And I had to repeat the story about Paul. Yeah.
Sanjay Bhai, just one more question to you. Well, I mean, like, you know, school is a kind of a sum total of an environment, right, that actually carves out a difference and the personality, all right, of the students. Now, any particular teacher you would like to recall with a lot of gratitude, all right, from St. Michael's, you know, whom you regarded as a mentor or as a friend, philosopher, and guide?
Yes, of course, and that's not difficult at all. And it's a very unlikely candidate, because Mr. Tarafdar taught us geography, and there are very few of us who offered geography as a subject in Cambridge. But geography was an obsession for me. And although I was not very, shall we say, passionate about many subjects, with the result, I never excelled in any. But in geography, I was very confident that I would pass out with flying colors and without too much effort. And Taratar was an incredible storyteller to start with. So when he would talk about the savannas, he would talk about, you know, as if he was standing there and looking at the animals. When he talked about the Canadian shield, the loneliness, the barrenness, and the richness of the ore and the metals which lie underneath the surface. So I'm very grateful to Mr. Taratan that way. He left a very strong impact on me. And Hindu College didn't offer geography. Otherwise, I might have taken that as a subject.
Okay. Thank you, Sanjay Bhai. Yes, I remember Mr. Narayan Das Taravdar, Mr. N.D. Taravdar, our geography teacher, also, you know, very affectionately. Now, I'll just now move on, with your permission, Sanjay Bhai, yeah. I'll move on to Mr. Chandramani Singh.
Yeah.
Right? Chandramani.
Yeah.
Good evening and welcome once again to this wonderful, wonderful, wonderful initiative, you know, taken by Nishant. All right. And I'm so proud of all of you. And of course, Chandramani, I'm sure, has some wonderful, wonderfully crazy memories and crazy friends, okay, who made the school days so beautiful and so sweet. And Chandramani, I still remember it was my first day of class in standard 9, all right? And you had asked me a very, very intelligent question, which I'm not going to repeat at this, you know, over here at this point of time. And I could guess, I mean, the whole class was stunned, all right? And and I was a new teacher, very young, 26 years old. And then they were all, and you were the one, you know, with that naughty glint in your eyes. How is he going to handle that question? But yes, I handled it to the best of my abilities, and you were satisfied. But I knew that this guy is going to go miles and miles and miles. So please, anything, any friend whom you recall, with whom you had, you know, you had many with whom you had crazy memories, and of course, or a teacher. And I'm sure I remember Mrs. Gauri Ishwaran was always very, very close to you. All right. I remember the details. Over to you, Chandramani.
Yeah, I think there are many, many, many stories. But incidentally, if you remember very well, I think there was we sang a song together, that Hadsa song, which I was part of your team. So yeah. Mumbai Shahar, Hadsa Ho Ka Shahar, and I think So yoga. I think I was part of that. But one thing, incidentally, which really I can never forget. I was very fond of cricket, and incidentally, it happened in class 8 itself. As Sanjay ji just mentioned about it, something that the incident of that poor, the very interesting thing. And I remember it was a cricket match between St. Javier's and Michael's, which was being played, and we were guys, and it was during school hours, and we guys were so fond of. We really desperately wanted to see that match, but at that time it was Father Allen. And he said, no, nobody can see it. So we used to, you know, some excuse, sir, we need to go to toilet or something. And I was caught by Father Allen bunking the class. And I still remember he had a solid hand. He gave me a real big whack on my bumps, and it really pained for hours and hours. So that's something which I remember. It was really, really something which I can never forget. I always tell my kids, look, but that was any. I was happy it was my bump only. Otherwise, had it been somewhere else, it would have really hurt very bad. That's something which I still, and there are many, many, many more incidents, which one was definitely we used to look forward to. The cricket matches, which we did during our times, the blue bus was introduced. So we were picked up in the first slot. So we had a lot of time before the school used to start. So we had 1 hour to ourselves. And so we used to play a lot of cricket in that tennis court. So it was something that was really interesting. And by the time we used to go to class, we were drenched. It was, you know, the shirts and all, you know, okay. The whole day it used to stay. So it's
Because Nishant has, you know, some real serious stuff, good stuff, all right, which would be a big motivator, you know, for the kids who must be watching this particular, you know, webinar. Just one or two memories with teachers, actual subject teachers that you would like to recall, you know, from St. Michael's.
Definitely, it was not on the. I still remember Mr. Robin Francis. That was. And one good thing, it was for a different reason. Mr. Francis was very, very fond of Mukesh. And incidentally, very fond of Mukesh. And incidentally, Mukesh happens to be one of my favorite singer. So that was a real instant connect, and maybe because of him. So a lot of that's something I used to have long, long sessions, even after the tuition hours and all. So exchange cassettes, that time you had the LP and EP records and all.
Yeah, which is your most favorite Mukesh Mathur song?
Quite a few. I think
Chansin
Mehbooba.
Okay, that's mine as well. In fact, I sang it to my wife. All right.
We would like to, you know, just sing a line of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. हाँ तुम बिल्कुल वैसी हो जैसा मैंने सोचा था हाँ तुम बिल्कुल वैसी हो जैसा मैंने सोचा था
Wonderful, Chandramani. You joined me with yoga, and today I have joined you with Chansi Mehbooba. Okay. Yeah. So thank you so much, Chandramani, and thank you so much, Mr. Sanjay Singh, all right, for this, you know, recalling some wonderful memories, and I'm sure, you know, this is going to take and inspire. And of course, lots of teachers, you know, who are still watching you, you know, would also feel wonderful. I mean, like, you know, a teacher loves to be remembered. And you students always make teachers feel much, much bigger than what, you know, maybe the teachers were or the teachers are or the teachers will be. And that is the greatness of this student-teacher relationship. Okay, thank you. Nishant, now it's over Fantastic. To you and to do yes, the serious yes. stuff. Okay, I have done.
Yeah, Sanjay, right. I'll come to you. So if you all know about Sanjay Bhaiya served Tata's for over 40 years. He was the principal resident executive, and post his retirement, he became the advisor to Tata Sons. So, and he has been working with people like Rusi Modi, Jamshedji Rani, which is itself is a big thing. Sanjay Bhai, I would like to hear this story because not many people know that Vistara, when you see Vistara, it is Sanjay Bhai was extremely instrumental in bringing Vistara to what Vistara is currently. It's a Tata SIA collaboration. So, Sanjay Bhai, could you please throw some light on this?
Well, it concerns St. Michael's in a way, because when I was told that Tata were going to set up an airline in partnership with Singapore Airlines, I was asked to find out what were the formalities about completing an application for starting a new airline. I thought an application meant, you know, a few pages. I didn't realize it meant a few thousands of pages at that time. So how to find out, you know, well, I didn't know the very first step other than, you know, what do you do when you go to the DGCA? Well, the first thing is to find out who the DGCA is. And when I asked, I was told it was one Arun Mishra. At that time, I didn't know that it was Arun Mishra of St. Michael's, who I knew very well. I gave him a ring and we set up a meeting, and I told Arun, I said, tell me, how do we go about this? And Arun was so generous. He says, you know, I will cut short your time by 6 months. What I'll do is I will chair a meeting and you call all your chiefs of operations for Singapore Airlines, the chief of quality, the chief of navigation, the chief of safety, the chief of services, etc. And I will have the concerned inspectors from the DGCA sitting on the opposite side of the table. I will make them exchange cards. I will hold the initial discussions and tell them that hereafter, you all take it forward. He says, you know, you all have not got the NOC yet. But so technically, I should not even be entertaining this conversation. But he says, I know you will get the permissions, and it is in the interest of the government of India to have a success story in the aviation sector very soon. Because this was very soon after the fiasco of Kingfisher Airlines. The government was desperate to show a success story to the country, and Vistara was the most likely candidate. So that was one of the stories regarding Vistara. And the second one which I would like to say is on one of those visits to the DGCA, I used to know a captain for bowler. I used to play golf with him sometimes, and I asked him, I said, Captain, tell me, how do we go about filling an application? He says, you know, when you cross my door to the other side, there is a person called Mr. Ved Prakash. He is the authority on filling the applications for a new airline. But between my door and his door is a corridor. And the corridor is infested with sharks. You will meet many a person who will come and introduce themselves to you as a consultant. And everyone will claim this. Someone will claim, I wrote the application for Deccan. Someone will say, I wrote the application for King Air. He says, don't believe any one of them. remember, you are Tatas, you are supposed to give consultancy and not take consultancy. And I remembered his words very much, you know. And I'm very proud to tell you that out of the 1400 pages of the application, not one sentence has been written by a consultant. It was, we burnt midnight oil, experts came from Singapore, put up at a Taj Hotel in Gurgaon, and we wrote the application. And that has incidentally become a benchmark. So now if you go to the DGCA and say, how does one make an application for a new airline? They say, study these documents, and this is the benchmark.
Superb. Great, Bhaiya. It's a very motivating story. So I'll come back to you again. I will go to CM Bhaiya again. CM Bhaiya, knowing your professional achievements, so you were the head for LG at one point of time. You had made Videocon. You signed the World Cup contract for LG. You signed a Videocon contract for IFA. So many accolades which run through you. I would like to just understand briefly about your corporate successes, what we have tasted and we have seen in you, sir.
It's joining this corporate world itself was also an accident. I'll say all my fellow French colleagues. So while we were in Delhi University, I was also one of them, an aspirant for civil service. And I remember 1991, and that year, I was taking my mains, and unfortunately could not make it. So, and really, I really studied really very hard for it. So it was something like, one fine day, Asman se gire khajur, but it was nothing. So you had nothing to do. So, and again, I'll just add a story to it. So my now wife, so we were doing study. So it was something we wanted to get settled. So suddenly the civil service, we thought I'll make it. Nothing happened. So there was an ad in Times of India, I very clearly remember, which said they want MBA or Delhi University graduates. Fortunately, I had done my master's from the BU that way. And so she just asked me, fill the form up, why don't you go? And anyway, I went there, Suryakaran building in Kasturba Gandhi Mag, I still remember. And the rest is history. I joined Usha and never looked back. After that, immediately I moved on after 1 year to Onida and then to launch LG in India. And subsequently Videocon, and then I started my own. So it was just a sheer luck. It was a blessing of my parents and all my friends and all. So it just entered at the right time. And I think 1990s was the time where entire corporate world, I think this was something which was growing. So I was part of that growth, and fortunately things went pretty well for me, and hence everything fell in places.
Fantastic. We would also like to know that how is it that a Michaelite who has passed your school say about 20 years down the line, but I'm sure you still meet your old classmates, 30, 40, 50% of them every now and then. So what is the secret of that?
One thing I must appreciate, I think that there is a real, we have first time associated with, I go to Patna very often because I got my house still there. And as I said, I have my work also. So nearly I make it an effort to be there every month. And we have our own group as well as the Alumni Association of the Patna Alumni Association. I was also once secretary of that. I miss out this Nizamuddin event, which is every year. That's some fantastic, I think, kudos to all the who has everybody, Amitabh and everybody, I think, Mr. Azad and all, they have made it up. Huge success. So and there are lots of WhatsApp group. I'm part of all of them. So we are very well connected. We meet, and it's something like the school day friendship is something which you can never forget. It's something like we all are equal. We did so many stupid things. And yes, very, very well connected, both the Patna chapter as well as Delhi chapter. And because of WhatsApp and other applications, we are in regular touch. Every day you have hundreds of WhatsApp messages shared and all. So I think, yeah, and once a Michaelite, always a Michaelite. I think we the Michaelites, they bond always. It's something. It's though I've studied in DPS, I've studied in DU, but then Michaelites is something different. You can never forget them. It's something different. No, I think not audible there.
So I'll go to Sanjay Bhaiya again. Thanks, Bhaiya. Sanjay Bhaiya.
Yes.
We would like to know that you being in Delhi, handling both the UPA government and the NDA government at different times for Tatas, what was your experience with that particular corporate take-ups?
So we are talking about a span of something like 18 years that I have been here, and the first 2-3 years of that was the NDA, that was Bajpayee's NDA. Then came 10 years of UPA, and then again the new version of NDA. Well, one thing I can tell you that when India Shining was coined, actually India was really shining. Unfortunately, a slogan like that, the opposition was very quick to jump onto that and said, how can you say India shining when there are people starving and India is developing? Well, that's true. Politically, it was not a very savvy statement, but India was shining. And I think the government had just got into a listening mode. It was a very stable government. It had stalwarts as ministers. The bureaucrats were very comfortable and working was a pleasure. Then came UPA. It's not that there was a change, and one is not criticizing, but the culture was, you know, quite different. But still, one good thing is the government continued to do two things. One is take advantage of technology. And so when it was not necessary to go chasing files to Shastri Bhavan, Nirman Bhavan all the time. You know, much of the work was being done on the net, and with time that increased. And now, thanks to COVID, now all the work has gone onto the net. It's you're not required to visit those buildings anymore. So that is one aspect. That is over the 18 years, how technology has taken over and completely transformed the experience of working with the government. The second is, the world had just started taking interest in India, serious interest. So from 2002 onwards, as time went by, the interface with the various embassies, with the commercial counselors, the ambassadors, increased tremendously, and from countries which were just a blob on the net, and we had delegations from there, and being from the Tatas, we were always the first port of call. So anybody who brought any new technology wanted to partner us. Anyone who thought, you know, they could dig into Tata's coffers, you know, would come looking if we would invest in their projects. I'm not with the Tatas anymore strictly, but I still have emails very often where people, you know, ask me how to go about setting up a joint venture with the Tatas, etc. So this is something I have seen the change in 18 years. Technology has driven it. And one more thing, working has become much more transparent. I've never been harassed for, well, what somebody should not have asked, probably because I was from the Tatas, but now, with the application of technology, there is speed equity. If somebody sits on your paper, the first person is answerable, and which has put the power balance between the private sector and the government. It has put a little more power into the hands of the private sector.
Fantastic, yeah, it's a superb insight. So let me welcome the super cop of the country, Bhaskar Bhaiya. Welcome to the incredible Michaelite show. So let me give a brief of Bhaskar Bhaiya. Bhaskar Bhaiya is President Police Medal in 2008 and 15, plus United Nations Meritorious Award, and currently he's with the Karnataka Police as Commissioner of Police Bangalore. He has done some wonderful work on the coronavirus crisis. And a small story, when we started, Karnataka was in the first five of the country. Within 14 days, with his all experiences, the way he controlled it, Karnataka was not there in the top 15 list. Which, you know, a lot of credit goes to him as well. Welcome, Bhaiya.
Thank you, Nishant.
Tell about yourself, sir.
Well, I'm from the 1982 batch of the Indian Police, of the ICAC batch, Michaels. And my heartfelt regards to Sanjay Ji, who is a senior. And I have the highest regards for all the Michaelites who have done exceedingly well. And any institution, if its value has to be determined, is done by the alumni. It is alumni who speak loudly about the institution and nobody else. And I'm delighted to be a part of the alumni. With the grace of God and the blessings of my parents and the guidance given by my teachers at the initial level in St. Michael's, that I'm able to come up to this level. As Nishan pointed out, and as Sanjay Ji also was mentioning about technology, etc. Today, we are all here having a virtual meeting, which would have been impossible. In our time, we never thought that such a technology could ever come into our life or during our lifetime, or we could never imagine in our science fiction also. Being Commissioner of Police Bangalore has been both extremely rewarding and extremely challenging, as this is the ambition of every IPS officer who has been serving in Karnataka to be the CP of Bangalore. The Honorable Chief Minister and the government have placed immense trust in me, and people of Karnataka, especially Bangalore, are outstanding, very, very good, and with their help and with their support and cooperation, we were able to successfully tide over the CIA problem, which had a lot of issues all over the country, as well as the global pandemic through which we all went through right now. And then we are emerging stronger and stronger. And humanity has seen several pandemics in the past also. I'm sure we'll overcome this too. Taking my roots back to St. Michael's, I cherish my roots of being the one or two South Indians in the whole of 1,500 Michaelite students, Michaelites. Even today, whenever I come across anybody from Bihar, I remember them as very, very my fond friends over there, and the kind of values our teacher gave, especially when I joined, it was Father Rennie Harland who was a principal. Then the excellent teachers like Mrs. Mari McDonald, Mrs. Baljinder Kaur, Mrs. Rosario, and then our Hindi, Mr. Fernandez, our mathematics teacher, Mr. P.S. Raj, Mr. Thomas, and all these memories come gushing into my mind, because these are the people, the teachers who are responsible for what we are today.
Fantastic, yeah.
Fellow Michaelites is also a very, very rewarding experience. My best wishes to them. And on the lighter side, we remember our rural canteen, cycle stand, farm and gardening club, etc. Extremely enjoyable time, and our anticipation of socials with Notre Dame, and sometime our refusal of socials with St. Joseph's College. And Mary McDonald, madam, had very jocularly mentioned, let the reverend girls and the reverend sisters be where they are. Notre Dame girls are there for the school. Our lovely memories of school. And wherever a Michaelite where I meet over there, it is a rewarding experience. But now Michael's are expected to include, which is a great change. Just come on the centuries old institution. Even now in Bangalore, I keep myself very much attached to any of the SJ institutions, and they also receive me with a lot of respect and affection. Thank you so much.
So I'll tell you, Bhaskar Bhaiya, your school part is going to be taken up by Ambar sir. So Ambar Banerjee. So Ambar sir, I think you can unmute and
Ambar sir was Ambar sir, I was briefly there. I used to see Ambar sir, but I had not done my plus two there. So I knew Ambar ji, and I've met Ambar sir also, but I have the highest regards for Ambar sir, and our batchmates keep making a lot of positive mentions about Ambar sir.
Yeah, he will ask some anecdotes of school. I think if you can unmute, sir, and you know, the stage is yours.
Okay. So, hello, Mr. Bhaskar Rao. As they say, a Michaelite, you see, if you are studying in St. Michael's, you are a legend in the making. Then, as George Orwell said, all right, all legends are born equal, but then some legends are more equal than the others. All right, so here we have three of those legends, all right, who were perhaps more equal than the others. Well, I was also a Michaelite, Bhaskar. In fact, I missed teaching you because I think my first batch, you know, was of standard 12 of 82, standard 12, yes, passed out in 83. Okay, so yes, I mean, like Miss Mari McDonald, whom you fondly recall, was my very, very helpful, cooperative, you know, senior, and you know, a facilitator and a guide for me, who helped me settle down as a teacher over there. As it is said, sir, that good times and, as I was saying, crazy friends, all right, make some wonderful school memories.
Very true, very okay? true.
Yeah. Now, could you just, you know, especially for the youngsters, I mean, like the ones who are already, I mean, who are studying in St. Michael's, who are in school, could you just recall, you know, any one of your so-called crazy but very sweet friends for life, and also one of your, you know, any particular incident where you, all right, the highest, you know, ranking police commissioner, all right, who has won the esteem of everyone, indulging in something which was a sweetly crazy?
I must tell this to you, sir, that when we were in 9th and 10th standard, that was in 1980-81, and we had the opportunity of going by cycle to villages around Ara during flood-affected times. With me used to be Prem Prakash, Vikas, Podar, and Jain.
Oh, yeah.
And we were so poor. Poor in the sense means we had no money with us. We had all of us put together, we might have had about 10 or 11 rupees with us. And when we went to those villages, the villagers gave us sharbat. Sharbat means water with only jaggery and with only one nimbu. And we cherished it with great delight. And we had some lai. Lai is that very light, which is koki hum log gud mein mila ke banate hain. And it used to be only about 20 paisa or something. And that was our lunch. And we cycled some 40 kilometers just to go and see the plight of villagers. And there is a small village on the outskirts of Patna in front of St. Michael's called Kotia village. As a part of our, I used to be part of the Interact Club over there,
yeah,
among youngsters. So we had been there with Mr. Jeff DeCosta. And we had very good memories of doing some social work, making nalas over there, connecting the main drainage to the subordinate drainage to the main drainage. And then one particularly exciting journey which we had was on a cycle. Soon after, when the Ganga Bridge was opened in 1982, Prem Prakash, who is now with the management of Delhi Public School in Delhi, and Neeraj Akhouri, who is the CEO of AC Cements, and myself, we three of us went by cycle from St. Michael's School up to Muzaffarpur, Prabhat Tara, and we had a real good time over there. And the best memories of me being in Patna was when I was, we are part of the leadership training service called the LTS. One Father George Peter was our mentor, and we used to have a lot of meetings and some camps where a lot of rudimentary leadership was taught to us. And that was the time when we got to meet our friends from St. Xavier's and girls from St. Joseph's, Mount Carmel, some from Notre Dame. And those are the times where I have had grounding on what is real social life, what is really public life over there. So these are some very, very interesting things. And especially the fete, the spring fair, which we used to have in our school in the month of March, that used to be a great event, which we used to all look forward to. And of course, a lot of things I don't want to tell the youngsters, but we did commit a lot of blunders and mistakes, but never anything sinful or criminal in nature, but very naughty in nature, of course. And every step was a learning experience. And today we look back at our teachers who probably must be in their 80s or in their 90s. And with folded hands and reverence, we regard for what all they taught us over there. And those are great periods, especially for those who were born between 1959 and 1979. This was a great time we had in St. Michael's. Thank you so much.
Yeah, in fact, very rightly said. Nishant, I'll just take one moment. I mean,
please go on.
All these Michaelites, you know, I mean, like, St. Michael's gave us such a wonderful exposure to holistic, you know, education and growth, personality development. But you know, any Michaelite going to in any walk of life or field would very confidently, you know, tell the you know the youngsters, look, typical Rajkumar style, okay, that tum jis school mein par rahe ho jaane, hum us school ke headmaster reh chuke hain. All right, so I'm sure that's holding Bhaskar in good stead.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Permit me to leave. Otherwise, Sunday would have been a free day for me. I had two important events over here. Film star, prominent film star has died. And a lot of huge crowds are there where VIPs are expected to go. And we have to ensure that social distancing is not compromised. And then we had a law and order problem in a containment zone where COVID-19 was prevalent over there. So permit me to go. My best wishes to Nishant for having brought me on here. And thanks Ambar sir and thanks Sanjay sir for having been on the panel. Thank you very much, sir. Namaste, sir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks for joining me.
And one more question. Ask Sanjay Bhai about his golfing achievements.
Yes, sir.
Over to you. Over to you, Nishant.
Yeah. So I will straight away come to CMBR. CMBR, we have seen the records. You still play those you know, crazy cricket matches between St. Michael's and St. Xavier's in Delhi. And it happens so regularly with routine that we all get surprised. And I've seen that you are actually the second highest scorer in that list of, you know, top scorers. Do you want to throw some light on this as well?
I think the all credit goes to Mr. Sharad Sinha. I think he's the one I must appreciate. He's the one who's been organizing for years all together. And basically, he pulled all of us. In fact, a lot of time, we refused. But I think we are so scared of him. Every time he khelna, you have to come. You have to come so many times, you know. It's something you are not in practice, but lasting for 50 overs, 25 each. It's not, you know, right from morning 9 o'clock or rather. We it's still, the discipline is, I must appreciate Mr. Sharad is, you got to be here by 8:30. So all of us, we are there. And then, you know, waiting for our turn to bowl, waiting for our turn to bat. But then again, it's a pure thrill. It's a pleasure. It's something, cricket was something which I think most of us, that was the number one sports all of us played. So it was something, I'll say, courtesy, it's again, I'll say, it's courtesy Sharad, he always invited us, and sometimes it clicked, sometimes it didn't, and being, maybe, yes, there were a couple of occasions we played, but there, yes, I may make always an effort, because this is something, still, whenever I can get an opportunity, but yeah, the next day is very, very painful, You try to give your best without any practice, but the next day it's really tough. So now, to definitely for last couple of years, I have not played. But yes, before that I was very, very regular. I think must have played for about 10-15 years on a trot. And I think the good thing was before I started playing, so it was totally skewed towards St. Xavier's. I think I remember the record every year they used to have this annual tournament. And it used to be maybe 80% matches won by Xavier, then 20% by Michaelite. But fortunately, by the time I left, it was all we won, because we had better players. I think we won most of the matches, 90% matches we won. So I think it was really good. The record, we set the record straight. So it was Michaels who had more wins than Xavier's by the time I left. And I think we have really real good players representing Michaels now. They are doing very, very good.
Superb. Yeah. Now let me go to Sanjay Bhaiya again. Sanjay Bhaiya, you've also been the president of the Bihar Cricket Association.
Yes.
So the cricket connects Michaelites and the Michaelite connects on cricket.
Yes.
So, you know, just let us know about your experience as the president of the Cricket Association and did you like it and how did it go?
You know, sometimes you have greatness thrust upon you. And In Jamshedpur, it so happened that the president of the Bihar Cricket Association always used to be a Tata person. And that is because the resources into organizing cricket, most of the resources would be contributed by the Tatas. And at that time, Keenan Stadium was, you know, the only world-class stadium, so to speak. I mean, not even, it wasn't world-class, but it was the best for what it was. And the quality of the pitch and the turf, that was superb. And we've got international testimonials on that. Now, it just so happened that my previous boss, Jamshed Irani, he had been president of the Cricket Association. He went off, came Mr. Shankaran, he went off. And then there was, when somebody had to fight for the position. So I was propped up by the Tatas to fight for the position, because I had been very instrumental in organizing all the one-day internationals which Keenan Stadium used to host, and also part of the group of the Tata Sports Club in Bombay, where Ravi Shastri, Raju Kulkarni, Lalchand Rajput, all of them used to play. So for me to float into that situation of responsibility was, of course, I had to fight an election to win the position, and I did want to fight because I had to fight a Michaelite. You know, Amitabh Chaudhary, who is now the board BCCI president. But I had to fight him. I didn't want to fight, but I fought and won. And for the next 2 years, I had cricket administration under me. My contribution to cricket was, you know, cricket would have gone out of Jamshedpur to Ranchi much sooner than it did. We kept cricket in Jamshedpur again for the next 2-3 years. And took cricket to the grassroots, took cricket to the youngsters. And some of the prodigies who you see Jharkhand producing just now, and some of them have played for the country. I remember Dhoni himself when he was under 19. And I remember I used to tell him that Dhoni, one day you'll play for India. And I used to tell him, because the Tata cricketers who had played for India used to tell me that watch out for this guy, one day he'll play for India. And Dhoni could believe it, you know, he would just grin, that's all. And so we took cricket down to the kids, and this has thrown up some outstanding talent.
Superb, Bhaiya. And CM Bhaiya, we also want to understand, you were the recipient of best salesperson worldwide for 3 years in LG. So what is that extra, you know, quality you have for this and you had for this?
Look, I think it is very much in all the people from Bihar. I think one thing I can vouch for that. All of us from Bihar, they're real hardworking, and especially even Mr. Bhaskar mentioned, like during our days, though we all guys, we did, you know, we all were naughty, we did mischief and all, but everybody was, everybody had talent, everybody was very, very hardworking. And I'll say, people from Bihar, I think they are a born salesman. Everybody there, they I have come across so many youngsters. These also, they are balls. They do very well. Even today, as a salesman, they do very well. Again, as I said, I was fortunate to join LG, to head LG, and it was something, you know, when you get something which you like, and I think sales and marketing was something which I really loved. And I took over as the national head in 2001. I remember I was posted in Bangalore, and then I came over to Delhi. And that time television was not doing well. So cricket and Bollywood, I think these are the two most important. I think in India, these two things are worshipped. And that's where, you know, I signed the 2003 and 2007 World Cup because I was heading LG. And we ran this campaign, Captains of India, where my rival company, Samsung, they had signed all, right from Mr. Virender Sehwag to Rahul Dravid, all were part of Samsung team. So we were not left with any cricketers. So we came up with the concept Captains of India, and we signed Dada. And along with Dada, we signed Sunil Gavaskar, Ravi Shastri and Shrikant. So we made this captain, and it really, really worked. It really clicked. So, you know, sales of television in India, I still remember the figures when I took over in 2001. We used to sell just about 2.5 lakh television at that point of time. And it just doubled every year. And by the time I left LG in 2005 before I joined TCS, we sold over 3 million television from just 2 lakh television. And that was majorly because of that Cricket World Cup and that signing with the cricketers and all. And then there was a GoldenEye technology also, which we did. So, yes, because of that, our sales, I was the number one across globally every year. You know, I used to double my sales 3 times, 4 times. So, in every time, you know, people were really, you know, I remember the Brazil subsidiary was doing pretty well, but they were really, every time I used to have a big fight, but the figure was courtesy cricket. We had such huge numbers to prove our point. So I think, yes, I'll give credit to, okay, besides my hard work and my team's hard work, cricket and I'll say that GoldenEye technology, which we launched.
Fantastic. I've seen a passion in sales and video economy, which we are, and you used to handle it with a very cool mind, which is not easy for anyone else to do. So I will come towards the end of it. It was a fantastic time. I would just have, would like to, Sanjay, I just give two lines for the Michaelite and the Michael days. What would you say to all the alumni? They're all watching you from all across the globe. And this digital property will be saved at a place where people can, watch it from anywhere and talk about it. And, you know, all these reminiscences are going to be the golden preserved in the main areas of their heart.
So I suppose you are asking me to give a word of advice to the youngsters who are still in school.
No, the alumni who you are the role model of.
So to the alumni, the message is, as always, to stay connected and to keep celebrating.
Fantastic. Superb. CMBA, same from you.
I think Sanjay sir, I think rightly mentioned, and yes, absolutely stay connected. I'll just add to that, East or West, Michaelites are the best. And I think they're great, great people. So I think, yes, let's meet more often. And wherever it is, I think I'm aware of Delhi chapter, I'm aware of Mumbai chapter, where Kolkata and Patna. So definitely, yeah. Yes, let's have more regular meetings. And it's a brilliant initiative taken up by you. And this will definitely make us more connected now. So it's a brilliant, brilliant thing. And with great to have Amber sir. I think we were one of the first batch of his. It's something which is really, really, anything, even the moment you got in touch with me about this concept of connecting with Michaelite, the kind of feeling which is, because it's, we started from class third, I remember that. That's when we class, and you were a kid. So it's something less. But, I don't have much to say, but yes, with Michaelite, yes, okay. Stay connected.
I think they've got a small video. So, it's more about the photographs accumulated. So, AB Uday will just run. For all of us.
Hit, 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 hit
chapel. Yes. That was near. You see, that was near the infirmary.
And then by the Ganges swimming pool. So
you all cherish. Samosa never tasted so good. It was never.
It was
the best ever we had.
Yeah, and we were fortunate that we went to one of the alumni meet in Patna, and we had the same samosas served by Rudal's son.
Yeah.
So we were fortunate.
Especially the poolside party, the samosa used to be the main thing. I think we used to look forward to the samosa.
Thank you. Thanks, for your time. Thanks, CMBA, for your time. Alumni as well. And, look forward to the board. Next session, we are going to have Mr. Amitabh Chaudhary. We're going to have Dr. Divya Prakash from UK, the knee specialist, and we'll have Mr. Yashwardhan Sinha on that show. That's happening on 14th of June at 6 p.m. Please join us here to more Michaelites, more greater achievers of their lives. We will happy to know the story of everyone. So here we go. Incredible Michaelite. Let's know a Michaelite. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Sanjay, Nishant, and bye.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye. For God and country and humanity.
Yeah.
Thank you. For God and the country.